their original performance. So if you take a day off or 2 days off or a week off and you feel great, you weren't overtrained. You know, maybe you were in too high of a mental arousal. And that's kind of what I want to end this video with. It's getting kind of long, but hopefully you guys will stick around for the good part. So probably what is more common than central nervous fatigue, I'm not saying, I'll say probably kind of in a joking manner, because again, I don't think it's real, is people train in too high of arousal too frequently, right? So I'm talking kind of the poster boy for this, probably Lane Norton. But it's kind of hard to talk shit because Lane Norton's one of the strongest people in the world in his weight class and natural and all that stuff. But there's a big difference from going into a set and kind of in a emotionally a big difference going into a set, you know, thinking that the world is against you and you're blasting your music in your ears and you're slapping yourself in the chest, you're sniffing ammonia, and you're the fucking man, you're gonna do this shit. That's probably gonna hamper your recovery, right? Because again, this book will teach you a lot about stress, but your body, you just kind of ramped up your stress response, right? Which may be fine if you're trying to break a world record or do well in a meet or something like that. Because again, who cares about what you're doing tomorrow or the next day? You're what you train for is today. It's the Olympics, it's a powerlifting meet, it's whatever. Go ahead and do that. Not everyone needs to do that, but it's perfectly fine to do that in that situation. The problem comes when you try to do that all the time. It probably can hamper your recovery just from a mental exhaustion standpoint, right? Which is not central nervous system fatigue. It's just kind of a mental exhaustion of, holy shit, I have to get so amped up to do this every day. I don't know if I can do that, right? The comical thing, I think I heard this from Mike Zordos, was like, could you imagine going into work on Monday at 9 o'clock, clocking into your job, and walking in there and go, I'm gonna fucking cross this shit. Give me that pen and paper. I'm gonna fucking do these stats. I'm gonna fucking do my taxes. Like, you would be exhausted by noon. You couldn't make it through a day, let alone a week, right? But some people feel like they're gonna train 4, 5, 6 days a week like this and be able to sustain it over weeks and months and years. And the kind of the funny thing is, most of the top lifters you see, like Mike Teixeira is a good example of this, he'll just get under the bar, no music, do his little thing, walk out 700, hit it for a triple, rack it, turn off his camera. Like, I just squatted 700 for a triple, right? Chad Wesley Smith is like that too. We'll just like double 800 and then be like, what up, talk to somebody. So again, that's probably my biggest piece of advice for people who claim central nervous fatigue. I know I kind of just ranted a little bit in this video about how it's not true, because it's not true, at least in my opinion, from what I've seen in the research and an observation, but probably a better way to go about it, if you feel chronically fatigued, I'm almost certain it's a mental thing. You're getting too aroused for your working sets, right? You don't need all of that arousal just to hit a top triple, right? If you hit a top triple and it's smooth and it's whatever, you're gonna be able to recover better from that. I'll probably write a blog post about this as well, but one of the things that I've been doing for probably the past 4 or 6 months, when I finish my workout, I always kind of like sit somewhere in the gym, be really relaxed, and just kind of breathe for like 5 or 10 minutes, right? No mobility, no more whatever. Just before I get in my car and go home, I just bring myself down, right? I don't even train a high arousal most of the time. I'm pretty damn chill when I train. And I kind of credit that my ability to, I don't take deload weeks. I don't get mentally tired. I don't have CNS fatigue, right? Because I never really mentally amp myself up a ton. You know, maybe if it's like a test day, I'm testing the 2 rep max or 3 rep max or going for a big PR. I may get a little bit aroused, but nothing crazy. I'm not sniffing ammonia and shit like that in training. So those are kind of my tips about it, guys. Hopefully this video is informative. I'll break this up in 2 videos because no one's going to watch an 18-minute video. Go check out my website, myobrain.squarespace.com. There's a lot of cool stuff about there about stress, about what is called neuropsychophysiology, which is kind of how your brain and then your physiology are related, which is highly kind of related to this topic here. So go check out that stuff. There's a kind of a tab in there for that stress response stuff. go check that out. Again, the two books I recommend if you want to actually learn a lot about this stuff, Why Zebras Don't Get Ulcers and The Trouble with Testosterone. Obviously, you can go to Matt's website as well to get Squat Every Day. And I'll post a very, very good article he posted a few years ago about, I think it's called Central Nervous CNS Fatigue, The Limits That Are in Your Head. And it'll kind of be a lot of what I just said in this video, but he may say it better, right? So thank you guys for watching. Give me a thumbs up, like, subscribe, all that cool stuff. See you next time.